सर्वैक आत्म्यम प्रपश्यतः द नेचर ऑफ द नॉलेज ऑफ द वाइज पर्सन आप्ता शेष उपमर्थस्य त्यक्त्या शेषा सुखस्य च. सो वन हुज अटेन्ड ऑल द पुरुषार्थास एंड वन हैज बिकम फ्री फ्रॉम ऑल द पेन ऑफ सफरिंग दैट मीन्स निरतेश सुख अवाप्ति आत्यंतिक दुख निवृत्ति प्राप्तस्य परमं स्वास्थ्यम परमं स्वास्थ्यम प्राप्तस्य. So one who attained parama swasthya, for total abundance in one's own self, total comfort, the swasthya can be comfort. So one who attained a total comfort. Praptasya paramam swasthyam vada kim syat prajadvihi. So if one is comfortable without things also, then there is no need for that person to acquire anything. And so, that's all paramam swasthyam, swastata, swasmin sthitihi, one's abidance with oneself, which means that a total comfort with oneself, total acceptance and comfort with oneself, and a total comfort with everything. Vada kim syat prajadvihi, tell us what use would he have for the means such as prajaya, etc. Idi nischitya nissangaha pravarjanti eva sarvatah. Iti nischitya, having thus determined, nissangaha sarvataha pravrajanteva, the people who are totally detached, they renounce from everything. Dhavataha avidushaha drishtva mrutashnodakartinaha tattoya tattvet kaschit nahi dhavati mudhavat yathaivam. So, just as a person who knows the truth of the mirage water does not run just because he sees many people running towards mirage water, not knowing what it is, the person who knows, he doesn't run after them. And similarly also, yatha evam shrutitaha, thus shrutitaha, from the teaching of the shruti, tattvamasi, one who has known the oneness of the self. Ashesha vang manah kaya sadhana pravrutti visaya pratyayathatma jnani namiha. So one who knows oneself, the self, of all these means also and ends also. Avidya prasamvida dhishanan kamino naran putrutpatyadi sadhyeshu pravrutan vikshya yatnataha pravrutan vikshya. When he sees all these people whose intellect is veiled by the, covered by the veil of ignorance, and they were kamino naran, therefore who entertain a variety of desires. So when they see these ignorant people running towards acquiring the means of this putra, etc. So, yatnada vikshya, yatnada pravrittan vikshya, asmakam na pravrittisyat, kim vayam prajaya karishyamaha, asmakam na pravrittisyat, we cannot have any pravritti or any engagement with reference to these means. Krutarthatvachakarana, so two reasons were given. One is, one knows the athatma, the truth of all the means and ends. He doesn't run towards them. At the same time, krutasattvacca karanat, so one himself is fulfilled. Yad jnanat pravrittirya tad jnanasya kuto bhavet. How can there be pravritti, which is, by having gained the knowledge, there cannot be pravritti which arose from the ignorance of a given thing. If ignorance gives rise to pravritti, then knowledge will bring a cessation to pravritti. If there was a reason other than ignorance of pravritti, then that will remain. Even for a wise man also, appeasing hunger or quenching thirst, these pravrittis are not born of ignorance. They are born of Ishvara Srishti. That's the nature of things. And therefore, that will continue to remain. But his pravritti so far, to gain swarga, etc., to gain fulfillment by acquiring something, those pravrittis cannot be. Tasmat sarva pravrittinam hanisyat atmabodhatah. And therefore, by the knowledge of the self, sarva pravrittinam hanisyat, there will be total cessation of all the deliberate activities. The idea is that there is no desire or there is no motivation on his part to bring about any change in himself or any change anywhere for his fulfillment. I mean, he may continue to perform actions for nothing to gain for himself, that may be okay. And if he may respond to the needs of others, anyeccha prarambha, he may bring about changes also responding to the needs of others, but there is no need on his part to bring about any change.
Sadotpatte anutpadya anapyaschapi atmanah.
Since Atma is ever there, therefore, anutpadya is not to be created, anapya, not to be achieved, or not to be reached, let us say.
Asamskarya akriyangatvat.
Since Atma is not an accessory of an action or yajna, etc., therefore, asamskarya is not subject to any improvement or purification.
Nirgunatvat tathatmanah. Again, if there are doshas and that can be removed, Atma is nirguna, therefore nirdoshah.
Kaudasthyat avikaryoyam.
And since his kutastha is immutable or changeless, therefore also not available for any modification.
Vadasyat karmanahi kim. Please tell us, so this is how. Vadakim syat prajadvihi.
Vadasyat karmanahi kim.
What can there be to achieve with reference to?
By karma
for Atma.
So Atma also is not available for karma.
Whatever it is that karma can accomplish,
none of this is applicable to Atma, and therefore also karma cannot have any application reference to Atma.
All right, so we are now coming to the end of this discussion.
On the page 1295, the last but one line, last word in fact.
Kincha sataha asataha va karma anapekshatvat atmanasya sattvat tat anapeksha iti aham.
Kincha sataha asataha va karma anapekshatvat.
So that which is real has no apeksha for karma.
See, karma can bring about some change, karma can bring about some modification, whatever.
So that which is real, sat, has no need for any karma because it doesn't require, it is independent.
Sat is that which is trikale vitishtati,
so that which is independent,
which does not require anything else to support it, to illuminate, to fulfill it, that is sat.
And so that which is sat or real,
is independent. See, karma is applicable to something that is dependent,
that requires to be created, that requires to be sustained, that requires to be destroyed, whatever.
Atma has no expectation at all, and therefore, that which is sat or the real has no expectation of karma.
Asatahava, and that which is so non-existent,
asat here is non-existent, that also does not have any expectation of karma because it is non-existent.
Atmanasya sattvat.
So this is a general thing.
Sat and asat,
the real and non-existent,
the existent and non-existent, they do not require any karma.
Existent because it already exists,
and non-existent because it doesn't exist and cannot be brought to existence. Therefore,
none of them, karma has no application with reference to these two entities.
Atmanasya sattvat.
And Atma is sat.
Therefore, Atma does not have any, so karma has no application with reference to Atma. Idyaha
na ityadina. So next verse,
page 1293, the fifth line from the bottom.
Notpatyadi svatoyasya svada evastiyasya tata nutasya karma apekshasti karma apeksha tato nyatah.
Na utpatyadi svataha yasya svadeva asti yasya tat.
See, svataha yasya na utpatyadi.
So that which is there, which is existent and which is real,
utpatyadi, as we said, utpatti and apti and samskruti, vikruti, none of this is possible.
Svataheva asti yasya tat.
Because all of this is there by itself. In short, that which is self-existent and that which is already achieved, for that utpatti, apti, etc. are not applicable. Nudasya karma apekshasti. Therefore, it doesn't have any expectation for karma because it is already existent, it is already achieved, it is already pure.
Karma apeksha tataha anyataha.
So that which is different from sat and asat, that has karma apeksha. The idea is only mithya has karma apeksha. The real or existent and non-existent do not have karma apeksha. Only mithya has karma apeksha.
So, kastarhi, kastarhi karma apeksha. What it is that has karma apeksha? Tataha anyataha.
Tat prapanchayati. That is being explained here, elaborated in the next verse, utpatyadaviti.
Utpatyadav samarthamyat hetrumatram apekshade phalavat karma tatraiva tato nyatra phalam bhavet.
Utpatyadav samartham yad hetu matram apekshate.
So, yad utpatyadav samartham, so that which is capable of being created, etc., that alone has hetu, expectation of a sadhanam or a means. So, karma becomes means for utpatti, api, etc. And therefore, that which is capable of being created, etc., that alone has the need or expectation of karma.
Phalavat karma tatraiva. That alone karma can bring about some effect.
Tata anyatra aphalam bhavet.
And elsewhere, in that which is sat and asat, karma is aphalam, cannot bring about its effect because karma can bring about certain kind of effects.
So that which is available for those kind of effects, that is where karma can have application. Where such effects are not there, karma cannot have application.
The Tikakar explains on the page 1296.
Sadasad vilakshanasya anirvachyasya karma apeksha ityartha.
That's what this means.
So that which is different from sat and asat, anirvachya, which cannot define as sat and asat alone, has karma apeksha.
Nirvachyetu nitya sadrupe pratichi karma anarthakam.
Whereas in pratyagatma,
nitya sadrupe, so that which is ever true or ever real, that is pratyagatma karma anapeksha.
And says Atma Swarupasya Evam Rupatvebi Prakrute Parivrajya Kimayatam.
Atma Swarupasya Evam Rupatvebi.
Even though Atma is such, that means that karma has no application with reference to Atma. Atma is not available for in any way being affected by karma. So karma has no usefulness with reference to Atma. That is the nature of Atma.
Atma Swarupasya Evam Rupatvebi.
Alright. Suppose that Atma is of this nature.
Tathabi Prakrute Parivrajya Kimayatam.
What relevance does this have? That Atma has this kind of nature, what relevance does that have with reference to Parivrajyam renunciation, which is the subject matter in the discussion?
Tadaha Uktaiti.
Ukta hetu vala tasmat viditva atmanam atmana paravrajayu samastabhyah ishanabhyo dhritam buddhaha.
Ukta hetu vala tasmat viditva atmana atmanam atmana.
So ukta hetu vala
atmanam nitya muktatva adirupena jnatva tasya chaturvida kriya phala vilakshanatva lakshana ukta hetu samarthyat ईश्वरभ्यः बुधः द्रुतं प्रव्रजेयुः.
आत्मानं नित्यमुक्तत्वात् नित्यमुक्तत्वादि रूपेण ज्ञात्वा.
सो आत्मा इज नित्यमुक्त. इन दिस मैनर नोइंग द आत्मा,
तस्य चतुर्विध क्रियाफल विलक्षणत्वात्.
एंड सो आत्मा कैन नॉट बी क्रियाफल
बिकॉज इज नित्यमुक्त नित्याप्त कूटस्थ निर्गुण.
एंड देयरफॉर whatever it is that kriya or karma can do has no usefulness with reference to atma, and therefore chaturvidha kriya phala vilakshanatva lakshana, atma is vilakshana, altogether different from the fourfold results of an action. So tal lakshanokta hetu samarthya, so that's the lakshana of the atma, and on account of that Eshana Dibhya, Eshana here means the sadhana actually. Eshana, of course, that also we explained. Eshana here means Putra Eshana, Vitta Eshana, means the various means which are the means for attainment of different worlds. And therefore, one becomes totally disinterested with or indifferent with reference to the various means which are the means for attainment of limited ends. And Atma is Nitya Mukta. Therefore, now no end is to be attained. Therefore, there is no use of any means. And that is why Atma being such, therefore, the karma has no application. Therefore, all this Putra, Vitta, etc., which are all the means of the nature of karma, also have no application. Therefore, Eshana Dibhya Udaha Dhritam Pravrajayuhu. Therefore, the wise people should immediately renounce from all activities. Tasmat avidvasanyasa jnanangatvena vidvasanyasa tatphalatvena siddha ityatha. Tasmat, therefore, avidvasanyasa jnanangatvena. That avidvan, even mumukshu, who is ignorant, but one who has got vairagya and mumukshuta, that person should renounce also, because their renunciation becomes a anga, becomes a necessary accessory for knowledge. And as far as the wise person is concerned, it is something that happens in due course. So wise person doesn't have to try for sannyasa, he is already sannyasi, and therefore there is no need for vidhi there. But then it's what we call anuvada, something that is going to happen. So with reference to ignorant person, this is vidhi. With reference to wise person, it is a statement of fact. And therefore, sannyasa siddha in any way, so sannyasa siddha. Sannyasa, renunciation must be there. So, this is the Icchantaha Etameva Pravrajano Lokam Icchantaha Pravrajanti. This is the Vidhivakya. So, this is Vidhivakya. And Etadhasmavai, this is the Arthavada. Arthavada supports the Vidhi, that's the idea. We are in that page itself now. So, page 1296. Sri Dhanagiri, Vakyantaram Prashnadvarena Avatarya Panchamikam Vyakhyanam Tasya Smarayate. Vakyantaram, the next Vakya. So, Kim Praja Karishyamaha Yeshamna Ayam Atma Ayam Lokayati. This Vakya has been done. Vakyantara, the following vakya is Tehasma Putraishanayasya Vittaishanayasya Lokaishanayasya Vittaya Atha Bhikshacharyam Charanti. That's the following vakya. Vakyantaram Prashnadvarena Avatarya. That is being introduced, you know, through a question. Panchamikam Vyakhyanam Tasya Smarayati. That this vakya has already been explained and greatly discussed in the third chapter. This is what is just brought to our memory. So this is not new. This has been discussed in great detail earlier. Teva mityadana, says Vashyakara. Tevam sadhya sadhana samvyavaharam ninnantaha avidvad vishayoyam ite kritva Kim Krutavandaha Iti Uchyade. So Prashnadvarena Avatarya. So through a question, the next vakya is introduced. The idea is that the next vakya is an answer to a question. And what is that question? So stating that question, Bhashyakara so introduces the next vakya. Te evam sadhya sadhana samyamaharam nindantaha Kim Prajaya Karishyamaha. That means here, in fact, that is a ninda. Kim praya karishyamah? Yesham na ayam atma ayam loka. So those of us who desire this atma, the world of atma, what use do we have for praja? There is putra, vitta, etc. or praja and karma and upasana, which are means for the anatma loka. What use do we have for those means? For us who are desirous of atma loka. In this manner, all these means have been sort of condemned. Sadhya sadhana samvyavaharam nindantaha. So atma loka is that is already sadhya, and no sadhana is required. So sadhya sadhana samvyavahara, the entire vyavahara involving the means and the end. There can be vyavahara that does not involve a means and end. There can be vyavahara whereby one does not want to accomplish anything for oneself. In that case, that vyavahara will not fall in the category of sadhya and sadhana. A wise person can be doing things because he is sarva-bhutatma bhutatma. So he knows himself, the self of all. He doesn't have any individual agenda at all. So you can say that maybe God's agenda is his agenda. And therefore he is just fulfilling agenda of the samashti. In that case also there is nothing to be accomplished for himself. And he also knows the world is mithya, therefore there is nothing to be accomplished in real sense anyway. And still it goes on. That's also sadhya sadhana samvyavahara. This vyavahara or transaction of the nature of means and end is can be said to be there when there is something to be accomplished at one's own level. So one has a personal agenda, then alone it can be called sadhya sadhana vyavahara. So that kind of vyavahara they don't have. They don't have any personal agenda, and therefore discarding all the means which are meant to fulfill personal agenda, recognizing that there is no agenda, recognizing that for us who have this viveka or discrimination, we have no agenda. Even though the person may be ignorant, but one is viveka also has no agenda. The only agenda that can be is dispelling ignorance, okay. And therefore, atma vichara, and therefore shravanam mananam, that can be the agenda. But not agenda in terms of accomplishing something, agenda is in terms of getting rid of something. So agenda in terms of getting rid of that, which deprives me of myself, which disowns me, sort of, you know. So that is the agenda. There is no agenda of achieving something. Sadhya sadhana samyavaharam nindantaha. How? Avidvadvishayamiti kritva. Why then? If you are discarding them, condemning them, how come so many people are doing it? Avidvadvishayamiti. This samyavahara, this whole vyavahara involving means and end is all meant for ignorant people. Iti kritva. So thus, that this all this vyavahara is applicable only to ignorant people, and therefore we have no use for this means and end, and thus condemning them. Kim krutavanta. Then what do they do? Alright, kim praja karishyamaha. What use do we have with for praja, etc.? Alright, so what? Na karmana, na prajaya, na dhanena. So this karma, praja, dhana, all of these are means of attainment of these three worlds. So karma and praja and dhanam. Dhanam and praja are the means of karma anyway. Again, it's not that praja is a... So praja and dhanam, both of them are means of karma. And then dhanam is of two kinds. The manusam vittam and devam vittam. So all these cattle, etc. and the wealth is the manusam vittam, the human wealth. And the upasana, so meditation upon God is what we call the divine wealth. So they all become the means of karma. And upasana. Upasana also is included in karma. And therefore, with karma they achieve, and praja. So praja becomes a means for ayam lokaha. Karma becomes means of pitra lokaha. And devam vittam becomes means of swarga lokaha. What do they do then? Tyage naike amrutattvamanasuhu. So kim kritavanta? What did they do? Iti uchyate. That is being said by the Shruti. That is the next sentence. Tehasma. Tehasma. Kila. Putreshanayascha. Vitteshanayascha. Lokeshanayascha vyutthaya. अथ भिक्षाचर्यं चरन्ते इत्यादि व्याख्यातम्।
So they grow out of the desire for putra, desire for wealth, desire for the world, and atha bhikshacharyam charanti, and take a life of renunciation. A life wherein there is no pursuit now of these three worlds, that's all.
So one must adopt a way of life which is compatible to whatever it is that one wants to achieve.
That is why karma should not be given up as long as there are desires to be satisfied, because karma is the only means for satisfying the desires.
Now that people have grown out of desires, they must take to a life which is compatible to a life which is free from desires, and that is a life of renunciation, where now no one cannot fulfill desires because one has no desires. Therefore, bhikshacharyam charanti ityadi vyakhyanam.
There also bhikshacharyam charanti was explained, bhikshacharyam chareyuhu.
This vakya also was explained as a vidhi vakya, that this is in fact an enjoyment for bhikshacharyam or for renunciation for those who have grown out of these desires.
So, panchamikam vyakhyanam tasya smarayate, that this sentence has been already explained in the fifth, means the third chapter. Okay. Page 802, but that already you see.
Now, यद अर्थोयम अर्थवाद है तम विधिम निगमयति, दिस आल्सो अर्थवाद।
सो किम प्रजा करिष्याम तेस्म पुत्रेषणायास वित्तेषणायास, दिस इज सेइंग समथिंग दैट हैपेंड। एतद् दशम वै तत् पूर्व विद्वांस प्रजान न कामयन्ते, दिस इज द रीजन व्हाई द वाइज पीपल ऑफ द पास्ट दे डिड नॉट डिजायर प्रजा, एंड दिस मींस हैविंग ग्रोन आउट ऑफ दिस थ्री डिजायर्स दे टुक द लाइफ ऑफ रेनन्सिएशन, दिस इज लाइक भूतार्थवाद। This description of something that happened, what use does it have here? So, Arthavada has only use with reference to Vidhi. So, wherever Arthavada is there, Vidhi must be there. And so, Vashtakara says that this passage is falls in the category of Arthavada. Therefore, it must have Vidhi. Therefore, this Etameva Pravrajana Loka Michanta Pravrajanti, that must be Vidhi Vakya. Therefore, Pravrajanti must be understood as Pravrajayuhu.
Arthavada cannot be there. So that is what Bhashyakara says here.
That's why Anandagiri said, Yad Arthoyam Arthavada.
So the reason why this Arthavada is presented here, Tam Vidhim Nigamayati, that Vidhi, that injunction now, is being now Nigamayati, is being confirmed here, firmed up here, Tasmadavi.
तस्मात् आत्मानं लोकमिच्छन्तः प्रव्रजन्ति प्रव्रजेयुः इत्येष विधिः अर्थवादेन संगच्छते।
यू मस्ट प्रूव दैट दिस अर्थवाद,
इफ अर्थवाद इज देयर विधि मस्ट बी, दिस इज ऑल द फॉलोइंग द पैटर्न or the method of analysis that is established by the Purva Mimamsakas. How to analyze the Veda Vakyas? For that, the rules have been laid out by the Purva Mimamsakas, and following those rules, Bhashyakara here concludes, or rather firms up, that this is a Vidhi Vakya.
So this is an important Vakya.
Etameva Loka Michyantaha, Etameva Pravarajana Loka Michyantaha, Pravrajanti.
Tasmad, therefore,
this was earlier to say then Atma Lokasya Karma Sadhyat, since the world of the self is not to be achieved by the karma, therefore Atmanam Lokam Ichchantaha, those who are desirous of the world of the self, Pravrajanti, they walk away, that means they take to life of renunciation, Pravrajayuhu. Now it is, see grammatically, only Ling, Lot and Tavya. When these are there, then alone these are the statements of injunction or the command. Do this or may it be done. Now, Pravrajanti is not, it doesn't fall in the category of Tavya, Atma or Drashtavya, then it becomes a Vidhi.
But there is no Vidhi at all. And therefore, what is it?
Anveshtavya, Vijignyasitavya,
then it becomes Vidhi. But then Pravrajanti, See, this grammatical, this only present tense, and so there is no grammatical the validity for looking upon this or taking this as the vidhivakya. If Shruti said pravrajayahu, then of course all the discussion would not have been necessary. But in the Purva Mimamsa also, even where this ling lotapya is not there, there have been instances where those statements have been interpreted as vidhi. And so, agnihotram juhoti, they say. Then juhuyat, this is how it has to be interpreted. So, that is why all these elaborate discussion was there, to establish how pravrajanti must be understood as pravrajayahu. May they take to a life of renunciation. Idi esha vidhi arthavadena sangachate. See footnote 1 on the page 1297, arthavadena idi prayojakatvam tritiya artha. Arthavadena, arthavada becomes prayojaka. Arthavada becomes now the reason to look for a vidhi, to look for the injunction. And that's how this must be the vidhi, because arthavada is there. Arthavada prayuktaha esha vidhi sangachyate iti arthaha iti ahuhu. Some people, they explain, some tikakara explain. Arthavada prayuktaha esha vidhi sangachyate. Arthavadena sangachyate, arthavada prayuktaha, that is how it is explained, and that becomes visheshana of the vidhi. Arthavada prayukta esha vidhi sangachyate. You can say that this vidhi is compatible to the arthavada. Or on account of arthavada, this vidhi is quite proper. It is quite proper that this vidhi must be there, because arthavada is there for this must be vidhi, this must be. Now, vidhi is a very important thing. If you have to convince the Purva Mimamsakas that something must be done, you must, their Mahavakya is vidhi vakya. So according to them, vidhi alone, there is an injunction of the Veda, then alone you should do something. And therefore they say that there is no renunciation. Where do you find renunciation in Vedas? Now here and there some sentence may be there, you know. Yada hareva virajet, virajet, tada hareva pravrajet, and things like that, you know. So the day you discover Vairagya, that day you must take to life of renunciation. You may find sentences like this, where there is a definite vidhi. But here in Brihadaranyaka also, we find all these arthavadas which describe, which are in the present tense. And so, specific vidhi is not there. And that is why, what the rules that the Purva Mimamsakas have laid, based on those rules, now we have to prove that this is a vidhi vakya. So pravrajandi pravrajayuhu id esha vidhi, this injunction arthavadena sangachate is compatible to the arthavada, who is etad dasmai tat pura vidvamsah and dehasma putra shanayascha, so sangachate, so it falls very well, so it connects very well with the arthavada. Then says Anandagiri, Mahanubhavayam Atmalokaha Yat Tadartino Duskaravi Parivrajam Kurvandi Distuti Hetra Vivakshata Na Vidhi. Why do you call it Vidhi? Etameva Pravrajana Lokamichintah Pravrajanti is also Arthavadi Stuti. Mahanubhava Mahamahima Ayam Atmalokaha. So such great, so great is the world of the Self. So glorious is the world of the Self, that lokamichindha para yat tadarthinaha duskanapi parivrajyam kurvanti. Look at the greatness of the world of the Self, that the people who desire the world of the Self, they parivrajyam kurvanti, they take to life of renunciation, which is extremely difficult. So of course sannyasa or renunciation is considered to be extremely difficult to do. But so, tat arthinaha duskarabe. Duskaram, something that is very difficult to do. Even that renunciation which falls in that category, even that also they take to. That shows the glory or the greatness of the world of the Self. So, This is a statement, in fact, only to bring out the greatness of the self rather than injunction of the renunciation. That another way, so if alternative explanation is possible, then you must consider that. Suppose somebody, some Purva Mimamsaka, says that, wait a minute, this is not the statement of injunction of the renunciation, this is rather statement glorifying the self. So it is vidhi, eulogy, or it is praise of the Atma, so it is also arthavada. Arthavada also can be stuti or ninda, different kinds of arthavada are there. It is stuti yatra vivakshata na vidhi. So intention of the stuti is in stuti and not vidhi. Iti ashankyaha. So having raised that question, the answer is given. Ashankya means what? The ashanka is not stated. Keeping that ashanka in the mind, that somebody may have an ashanka like this, a doubt like this, aha, the doubt is being so replied here. Nahi iti. Nahi sarthavadasya asya lokastutya avimukhyam upapadyate. Nahi sarthavadasya asya pravyajanti iti vakyasya. So thing is that this vakya, etameva pravrayam lokamichandah pravajanti, arthavada sahita. So arthavada sahitam vakyam. This vakya is provided as arthavada. So asya vakyasya lokastutya, atma lokastuti paratvam. You cannot say that this vakya is meant for stuti of the atma, because this vakya itself is provided with a stuti. Oh, this vakya itself is provided with an arthavada, therefore you can't say that this itself is an arthavada. And so, tadeva prapanchayadi, so tadeva ukta anabhimukhyameva. That is not a statement for the stuti of the atma, so that itself is being elaborated, pravajantidi. Pravrajanti iti asya arthavadarupo hi etadhasma ityadhi uttarograntha. Pravrajanti, of that vakya, asya arthavadarupo hi etadhasma. So etadhasma, pura vidvamsa, that grantha is only of the nature of arthavada, which is meant to support this vakya. So therefore, sarthavada, this vakya is arthavada sahitam, and therefore, you cannot say that it is meant as a stuti, it is meant only as vidhi. Still, tathabi pravrajanti di vakyasya arthavada tum kim nasya. Alright, suppose pravrajanti is provided arthavada, by itself cannot be why it cannot be arthavada. Arthavada can also be arthavada or not. Iti ashankya arthavadas chayati. So says Bhashyakara. Arthavadas chayata na arthavadantaram apekshayata apekshatetu etad dhasma ityadi arthavadam pravrajanti ityetada. Arthavadas chet na arthavadantaram apekshita. Arthavada doesn't require another arthavada to support it. A stuti does not require another stuti to support it. You know? So arthavada doesn't require any other arthavada to support it. Whereas vidhi requires an arthavada to support it. That's the idea. Arthavadas chet. So this fourth footnote there. Arthavadas chet ityadi. So rudi ityadehe arthavadasya bharishi rajadam nadeyam ityadi vidhina ek vakyatva darshanat arthavadasya arthavadantarapeksha na yuktayadi sthitam arthavada adhikarane. This is already established there. So saha arodi, the Rudra cried. So when in the yaga, silver was given as dakshina, and then the Rudra cried. This is, you know, What relevance it is with reference to yaga? But then this is saying that look, when silver was given as dakshina, then he cried. That means silver should not be given as dakshina. Vaneshi rajatam nadeyam. Therefore, in this given kind of yaga, rajatam nadeyam, you should not give silver as dakshina, give gold as dakshina. That's what it means. Ityadi vidana ekavakyatva darshana. Thus we find that arthavada always ekavakyata, arthavada always has the same meaning to convey as a vidhi. Arthavada is no independent meaning to convey. That's all the way the vakyas are classified. As vidhi and nisheda and arthavada, anuvada, etc. Every vakya is classified. And every vakya's place is explained. So arthavada, so then there is swarthe tatparya. Only vidhi and nisheda, only a swarthe tatparyam, that means they in fact mean what they say. But then arthavada, anuvada, etc., they don't have tatparya in the swartha, they have tatparya in the vidhi. So saha arodit is a arthavada, it is tatpar eka vakyada, it is meant to support this vakya, barhishi rajatam nadeyam vidhi vakyam. So thus, vidhina eka vakyata darshanat, arthavadasya, arthavadantarapeksha nayukta. Therefore, one arthavada does not require another arthavada. Iti sthitam arthavada adhikaran. In the Purva Mimamsa, in arthavada adhikaranam, this has been established that vidhi has expectation of arthavada, arthavada has no expectation of arthavada. Iti. Nu vashyakana sthit arthavada sthet nu arthavada antaram apekshita. There must be a very detailed study, you know, of this Purva Mimamsa. Has to, because when you talk with them, when you discuss with them, you have to take them on their ground, not on your ground. Then you can bring them to your, then he becomes your disciple. That's a different matter. So the discussion takes place on their ground. With their all the nitty-gritties and all technicalities, whatever it is that their Siddhanta is, based on their Siddhanta, you must show that their Siddhanta is not right, you know, or our Siddhanta is right. Arthavadaschet na arthavadantaram apekshet. On the other hand, apekshate tu pravrajanditi etat etat dasma ityadi arthavadam apekshate. On the other hand, pravrajanditi, this vakya has a need or expectation of arthavada of the nature of etat dasma. Therefore, this is vidhi vakya, pravrajanditi, pravrajanditi eva or pravrajayuhu. This is how it is established in this long discussion. So there is Krodhapatra on that page, on the page 296. Tasmad atmanam lokam icchanta pravrajanti paravrajayuhu iti esha vidhi. So this is vidhi. Okay. So tasmad atmanam lokam icchanta pravrajanti paravrajayuhu iti esha vidhi. Arthavadana sangachyate idi bhashyam atrahu vartikacharya. With reference to this, that this is a must, this is something to be done. And that is what Vartikara also establishes with argument, with reasoning. And the explanation of these verses is found on the same page, 10th line from the top, after the iti. Sanyasa vidheyatvam uktam akshapati. Sanyasa vidheyatvam uktam. It is said that sanyasa is vidheya. The sanyasa is that which is enjoined. That is what is said by Bhashyakara. Akshapati. Somebody questions. Somebody questions that sanyasa cannot be enjoined. That's all. There is a very strong opinion that there is no such thing as sanyasa. So akshapati, therefore, this contention on the part of this Vedantin, that this is a vidhi of the enjoyment of sannyasa, is being questioned by somebody here. Natu iti or nanu iti, whatever it is, you know. Verse, nanu chātma prabodhena vidhi gochar langhinaha krita kṛtyasya muktasya विधिरेश कथम भवेत। ननु च आत्म प्रबोधेन विधि गोचर लंघिनः कृतकृत्यस्य मुक्तस्य एष विधि कथम भवेत। नाउ दिस इज अ डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ अ क्वेश्चन। आत्म प्रबोधेन ऑन अकाउंट ऑफ द नॉलेज ऑफ द सेल्फ विधि गोचर लंघिनः, देयरफॉर वन हु हैज ट्रांसेंडेड द रियलम ऑफ बीइंग एंजॉयिंग, यू नो व्हाट इज इट, को विधि को निषेध, निस्त्रैगुण्ये पथि विचरता को विधि को निषेध। सो द विधि एंड निषेध इज फॉर द पर्सन हु फंक्शंस इन द रियल्म ऑफ द थ्री गुणास, बट वन वाज ट्रांसेंडेड द थ्री गुणास, नॉट अवेल फॉर विधि। सो विधि गोचर लंघिन, सो वन वाज ट्रांसेंडेड द विधि गोचरता, द रीच ऑफ द विधि एंड निषेध। हाउ कैन यू से दैट द वाइज पर्सन हैज टू रेनाउंस, because wise person supposedly is beyond all the injunctions. Nanu cha atma prabodhena vidhi gochara langhinah, on account of the strength of the knowledge, one who has transcended this vidhi, kruta krutyasya muktasya, and so one who is kruta krutya and mukta, eshaha vidhi kathambhavet, how can this vidhi be for the one who is an enlightened person, who is a kruta krutya? One will accomplish everything to accomplish, that is to accomplish in life, and mukta. One is free from every desire and every need. How can there be? See, you can enjoin somebody, you can compel somebody to do something, only if that person has a certain need, that's all. This vidhi is compelling, do this, it's just a command. You can command somebody provided that person has some kind of a need. Then alone you can control him. So somebody can be controlled when there is a need. There's no control, no need, no control. I don't want it. I don't, that's it, you know. How long can you control somebody? And so controlling is always, that's how people control them. People are controlled by other people because of their needs, that's all. Some helplessness is there, some need is there, that's why they even prime ministers and presidents are also controlled. They say there are political compulsions. So when India exploded this atom bomb, should Pakistan explode or not? You know, the debate went on and he was compelled to explode the atom bomb, what they call political compulsion. If he did not do that, there would be a strong section in that country which would revolt against him and throw him out. So, of course, original compulsion is for him to remain Prime Minister. And that requires that he should not be thrown out. That requires that he should please those sections which are strong enough to throw him out. And to please them, he must do something. That is it. So, a lot of these actions taken by the leaders are what they call populist actions. Just to become popular or to please the people. Most of the decisions in India are of that nature anyway. Used to be. Now, there seems to be some change in trend, but otherwise, that is why the country will go to dogs, because you keep on pleasing this fellows, pleasing other fellows, and there is no consideration from economic standpoint. No, only politics. Politics means what? Wheeling and dealing, not even politics. And so that's compulsion. Thus, when there is a compulsion, people know how to wind the key, you know. So that is how they know. And that's how they'll be compelled. Even Veda also can compel somebody provided that person has compulsion. He has a need. I cannot do without something. Moment that is there, then I become vulnerable. That's all. Nanuche Atma Pravod. So anyway, Vidhi Gochara Langhinaha, Kruta Krutyasya Muktasya, all the six case, Vidhi Esha, Vidhi Resha Kathambhavet. How can this Vidhi be there for this person? Says the Tikakara, Natavat Avidushaha विदह संन्यासः विद्वत् प्रकरण विरोधात् नापि विदुषः तस्य प्राप्त विद्या फलस्य विधि अयोग्यत्वात् वैद संन्यास अयोगादित्यर्थः न तावत्। सो दिस संन्यास विधि प्रव्रजन्य प्रव्रजेयुः इज मेंट फॉर हुम? इज इट मेंट फॉर ए सीकर, फॉर एन इग्नोरेंट पर्सन? न तावत् अविदुषः विदह संन्यासः this cannot be taken away, the vidhi for sannyasa, for an ignorant person, for a seeker, vidvat prakrana virodhat, because the prakrana vidvan, etat dasma vetat purva vidvamsaha, all of these brahmana, so this vidvamsa, this is vidvat prakrana, that means this is in fact the discussion of the wise or enlightened people. So, in the discussion of enlightened people, you cannot say that this is vidhi for the ignorant people. And therefore, this vakya cannot be interpreted as a vidhi for an ignorant, even though he may be viveki, but ignorant, no. He is not in the discussion. Na pavidusha, nor can you say that this is vidhi for a vidwan. Tasya, prapta vidya phalasya. Because vidwan, the wise person, is the one who has attained vidyaphalam. What is vidyaphalam? Krutakrutyasya muktasya, gatasangasya muktasya, jnana avastya chetasaha, yajnaya charatah karma, samagram praviliyate. Here all, krutakrutyasya muktasya, prapta vidyaphalasya. So one who has attained the vidyaphalam, that is the krutakrutyatva. Vidhi ayogatsu vidhi gochara langhinaha. So, vidhi ayogat, that person is not available for vidhi. Vaidha sannyasa ayoga, therefore, they cannot vaidha sannyasa. You see, the thing is, when there is a vidhi that you must necessarily do that, then if this is a vidhi interpreted to be for a mumukshu, then this means that a mumukshu must necessarily take sannyasa. That means he must undergo a vidhi. Undergo a process of taking sannyasa, that is called vaidya sannyasa. That is what we call vidvat sannyasa. A sannyasa that happens in automatically. And vaidya sannyasa, a sannyasa that is deliberately taken by vidhi. If this is vidhi, pravrajayuhu, then the one must necessarily take sannyasa. That is called vaidya sannyasa. But this is discussion of the wise person. The wise person is the one who has gone beyond the pale of the vidhi or injunction. Therefore, this cannot be a statement of sannyasa, of injunction for a wise person. Nor can it be for the ignorant person, because ignorant person is not under discussion here. This is the question, this is the shankha here. Panchamuktam smaran pariharati. Panchamuktam. Smaran, what was stated in the past, in the third chapter, smaran, bring to our memory, pariharti, this shanka is now resolved here, pariharosyeti. Then the Natikara says, pariharosya chodyasya kahaulo brahmane khilaha yato bhani maya purvam nihata punaruchyate. Asya chodyasya pariharaha अखिल है परिहार है कहोलो ब्राह्मणे मया पूर्वम यतः अभाणी अतः यह न पुनः उच्यते. This question that you are asking has been in fact परिहार. This has been refuted. So अस्य चोद्यस्य परिहार है, the refutation of this doubt or this question, मया पूर्वम अभाणी. This अभाणी also is aorist and then कर्मणि प्रयोग. मया पूर्वम अभाणी, since by me This refutation has already been done in the Kahalo Brahmana in all detail. Therefore, ataha iha na puna uchyate. Here now we do not engage in the same discussion, refer to a discussion in the Kahalo Brahmana. This is how panchamuktam smaryan, reminding what was stated in the third chapter, pariharti, this doubt has been refuted. This questioning has been refuted actually. Tikagara obliges us by just what is it that was discussed there, you know. So, sakshatkarato va vaidya sannyasa nirasyate apada jnanato va. So, sannyasa nirasyate, vaidya sannyasa nirasyate. You are in fact questioning here the vaidya sannyasa, the renunciation to be taken by vidhi, for whom? Sakshatkarato va vaidya sannyasa nirasyate. Is this nirasa, are you questioning or denying the sannyasa by vidhi for a person who has sakshatkara, for a person who has the knowledge? Apata jnana vatova. So one who is a paroksha jnanam. Are you denying the sannyasa vidhi for the one with the paroksha jnanam? Or are you denying sannyasa vidhi for the one with apada paroksha jnanam? Paroksha jnanam means the one who is vairagya, who is mumuksha, and so one who is a seeker. For whom are you denying this sannyasa vidhi? Na adhyaha. Tasya vidya phalabhuta sannyasasya arthikatvena vaidhatva anupagama. So we also don't say that a wise person, that the Shruti enjoins sannyasa wise person, who is already sannyasi. Sannyasi by spirit, whether he is sannyasi by any kind of clothes or not, but he is sannyasi by spirit. Tasya vidya phalabhuta sannyasa. So for that person, for the wise enlightened person, sannyasa is the very result of the vidya. So very result of the very knowledge actually brings about renunciation in him. Neva kinchit karomiti yukto manyeta tattvavit indriyani indriyarteshu vartande iti dharayan. So he says, I don't do anything. He's already sannyasi. Navadvare puredehi neva kuruvan nakarayan. And so that is what we call sannyasa, which follows automatically, effortlessly, because this he has become the sannyasi in the real sense. And therefore the purpose of taking sannyasa as a lifestyle also is ultimately to achieve that sannyasa which is what we call vidvat sannyasa. So Swami Dayanji would say, a sannyasi has to become a sannyasi. That means a vaidha sannyasi has to become vidvat sannyasi. So na adhyaha tasya vidya phalabhuta sannyasasya arthikatvena. Artha arthikam is arthabhatti. It is automatically follows. Arthikatvena vaidhatva anubhagamat. Therefore, we do not say that the sannyasa of a wise person falls in the category of vidhi. You don't require vidhi. When something will happen automatically, why do you have to instruct somebody? Instruction is required when things may not happen automatically. Otherwise, it's all right. When you go to school, all right, go straight to school. But I will just do that. You know. So, when he leaves home, you go to school, all right, but I am going to school. So you don't require vidhi or instruction when it is going to happen anyway. When there is a possibility it may not happen, then you require instruction. Okay? When you come home from school, come home straight. Today, don't go to your friend. No. All right. If the fellow always goes straight to school, you don't have to tell him. He always comes home straight, you don't have to tell him. But if he doesn't, if there is a possibility, then vidhi may be required. For a wise person, the vidhi is not required because sannyasa is something that happens automatically. Even in sadhana panchakam also, vedo nityam adhiyatam, tadudam karma svanushthiyatam, so sushtun, all of this is going to follow. If a person studies the Veda well, he will necessarily perform the actions and join in that. And that action will become the worship of the Lord. And that will bring about the Antarkaran Shuddhi. So all of these statements in Sadhana Panchayam will be looked upon as statements of what will happen. In case that doesn't happen, then make sure that this happens. You know. And until this happens, keep doing that. So keep studying the Vedas until you are inspired to perform all those actions in a proper way. But anyway, sannyasasya arthikatvena vaidhatva anubhagavat. Since for a wise man, sannyas will automatically happen, therefore, this vidhi, you cannot deny vidhi for a wise person because there is no vidhi. Therefore, you cannot say that you are denying the vidhi for a wise person because there is no vidhi for the wise person. Then for the ignorant person you are denying, nadvitiya, that also you cannot deny. You cannot deny the vidhi for an ignorant person because it is there. In wise person is not there, therefore you cannot deny, for ignorant person is there. Nadvitiya tasya sakshatkarodeshena sannyasasya anuschedaya vidhi apekshatvad ityarthah. Apada jnana, one who is paroksha jnana. Thus a life of sannyasa is helpful, it is anga, it helps you, helpful in converting paroksha jnanam into aparoksha jnanam, this idea. So, paroksha jnanam requires. Paroksha jnanam means what? So, prasapratibandhakam jnanam. There are pratibandhakas are there. there is avaranam and there is samshaya and there is viparya, these pratibandhikas are there. And to remove this pratibandhika, you must take an appropriate lifestyle and sannyasa. Sannyasa doesn't mean just renunciation. Sannyasa means ad-brahma vichara. That must be understood. Sannyasa means a commitment to the pursuit of knowledge. That must be always clear. It is not that Bhashyakara is only promoting sannyasa here. No. He is promoting brahma vichara. And he is promoting sannyasa as a lifestyle that is most compatible to brahma vichara. And if you look at the Vedic Varnashram Vyavastha, a grihastha has no opportunity at all to do brahma vichara because he is busy. So many kartavyas are there from morning till evening, he will have no time at all to do brahma vichara. Therefore, he must be relieved of all his responsibilities so that he can devote himself to the brahma vichara. So, sannyasa means brahma vichara. Therefore, he said here, tasya sakshatarodeshana. So, this seeker, for him to have this aparoksha jnanam, sannyasasya anusthetaya viryapekshatvat. So, sannyasa is something that has to be in fact practiced or has to be adopted, and therefore, vidhi is expected. Therefore, you cannot deny that. Number one, are you denying sannyasa vidhi? If you are denying sannyasa vidhi, you are denying for whom? There are two fellows, either wise or ignorant. So, you cannot deny sannyasa vidhi for the wise because there is no vidhi. And you cannot deny sannyasa vidhi for the ignorant because for him to become enlightened, sannyasa is required. Now, the argument is done here based on, see, there are so many smritis and so many things are there in India, which is one of the good things, which is one of an excellent thing, but then it can also create a lot of confusion. Therefore, now taking some vakya from some smriti, the argument is that there is no sannyasa, says the Tikakara. Nanu vidushaha avidushovana sannyasaha. Somebody says, there is no sannyasa for an enlightened person or for an ignorant person. For a seeker, no sannyasa at all. There is no such thing as sannyasa. Why? Aikashramya smritehe. There is a smriti there is only one ashrama, grihastha ashrama, that's only. So there is smriti which emphasizes that the real life is only the life of a householder. There is no other stage of life, no other style of life. Aikashramya smritehe garhasthyatirekena ashramantar ayogat. Garhasthya atirekena ashramantar ayogat. So that smriti says that there is only one ashrama and grihastha ashrama, and therefore it does not permit any other ashrama. Sannyasa is a stage of life different from grihastha, is not permitted by the smriti, as that smriti. Therefore we say that cannot be sannyasa. So smriti also cannot say something that goes against the smriti. That's the idea. Smriti should not have said had it not been the spirit of the smriti. Yatha aha Gautamah. So this is how, where Gautama said, I do not know. I could not find it in Gautama Smriti, this statement. Aikashramyam tu acharyaha pratyaksha vidhanat garahasthasyaiti. So maybe there is some other smriti. There is a Gautama Smriti. Among the 18 smritis that we have, you know, Ashtadasha, 18 smritis we have. 18 Puranas we have, 18 Upuranas we have, 18 Smritis also we have. There are many other Smritis other than 18, but 18 Smritis are there, of which Gautama is one of the Smritis. And that is what is quoted here. Yataha Gautamaha Aikashramyam tu acharyaha pratyaksha vidhanat garhasthasyeti. Since garhasthasya pratyaksha vidhanat, since Shruti very clearly says that one must take to life of grihastha. That is very clear. The Vedas, there is no question about Vedas enjoining life of householder. Question is whether Vedas anywhere enjoin the life of a renunciation or not. But pratyaksha vidhanat, as far as garhastha is concerned, there is pratyaksha vidhanam. That means there is a very clear injunction in the Vedas. So, aikashram tu acharyaha pratyaksha vidhanat garhasthasya. Since garhasthyam or householder ship or householderness, life householder is very specifically enjoined by Vedas, so we say that there is only ashrama. We do not find this very clear enjoinment for the other ashramas. Aikashramyam tu acharya, that is why acharyas say there is only one life, one stage, grihastha. Iti tatraha brahmacharya, to this Vartikara replies here. Brahmacharyam samapyeti pratyaksha shruti mulatah chaturunam ashranaman syat nupekshato numanatah. Says no, for sannyas also there is pratyaksha vidhi. Brahmacharyam samapyeti, this comes from Jabal Upanishad. So there are Upanishads also many, you know, and therefore from some Upanishads you can always find something. So Upanishads will enjoin sannyas. Karmakanda will enjoy the Gaharastya, Upanishad will enjoy sannyasa, there is Jabala Upanishad, where also there is a dialogue between King Janaka and Sage Yajnavalkya. Atha Janakoho Vaideha Yajnavalkya Upasametya Vaacha. It comes from Jabala Upanishad. So that passage you don't have, but Atha. Thereafter, Janakoho Vaideha. So Vaideha Janaka Yajnavalkya Upasametya. Properly approaching Sage Yajnavalkya, Vacha said this, Bhagavan, Sanyasam Anubruhiti. So, Adihi Bhagavo Brahmeti. Similarly, here Janaka says, Sanyasam Anubruhi. Please tell, teach me about Sanyasa. So, I question about Sanyasa, in fact. Saho Vacha Yajnavalkya. To this, Yajnavalkya, Sage Yajnavalkya replied, Brahmacharyam samapya gruhi bhavet. So that's the vakya that is quoted here. Brahmacharyam samapya. Brahmacharyam samapya gruhi bhavet. Having fulfilled or having completed life of brahmacharya, one must take the life of householder. Gruhi bhutva vani bhavet. Having completed life of householder, then vani bhavet, one must take the life of vanaprastha. Vani bhutva pravrajet. Having concluded, completed life vanaprastha, pravrajet, one must take life of renunciation. Yadiva itartha. Or it can be other way also. So there is a krama and there is vikalpa. There is a krama in the sequence from one to the other. Vikalpa is jumping from one to the sannyasa. Yadiva itartha. Or it can be other way also. Brahmacharyadeva pravrajet gruhadva vanadva. Or else, one may take the life of renunciation from brahmacharya itself, or from grihastha, or from vanaprastha. Atha punaha avrativa avrativa snatakova asnatakova utsannagni anagnikova yadahareva virajet tadahareva pravrajet. Doesn't matter who he is. Atha punaha avrativa avrativa. Whether he is taken from vrata or not. Snatakova, asnatakova. Whether he is a graduate or not, completed the brahmacharya ashram or not. Utsannagni, anagnikova. The idea is that, so whether one utsannagni, one was given up the agni. See, what happens is, when one enters the life of a householder, from that day itself onwards, the husband and wife then perform the agnihotra. Now, if the wife dies, this person is no more qualified to perform Agnihotra. Therefore, he has to give up the Agni. It's called Utsannagni. Anagnikova. Oh, the fellow is, in fact, he is not taken to Agni at all, to either. Whoever he is. Avrativa, Vrativa. Snatakova, Asnatakova. Utsannagni, Anagnikova. One who is not even taken to life of Agni. Not taken to life of a householder. Whoever he is. That means without any qualification. The only qualification for parivrajakatva or the sannyasa is what? Yad ahareva virajet, tad ahareva pravrajet. The day he discovers vairagya or dispassion, that is the day when he should renounce. Yad ahareva virajet, tad ahareva pravrajet. A very famous vakya among the Vedantic students. So they always quote this. This is a direct injunction or direct, in fact, injunction, you can call it, or direct support, you know, for the life of sannyasa. Therefore, Vatika said, brahmacharyam samapyedi pratyaksha shruti mulataha. That pratyaksha shruti, that yadahareva virajet, tadahareva pravrajet. That's what it says. Or it says here, so mani bhutva pravrajet. So therefore, so parivrajya, there is a very direct statement also. If a garhastha, there is a direct shruti, also parivrajya, there is a direct shruti here. Brahmacharyam samapyedi pratyaksha shruti mulataha. So chat chaturnam ashramam syat na upeksha. There are all the smrutis, they talk about the four ashramas, including this Gautama Smriti. So I don't know where this vakya comes from, but Gautama Smriti as it is talks about all the ashramas. So then there is some shruti that says there is only one ashrama. Which smruti we should take as pramana? So that smruti alone should be taken as pramana, which has its source from the shruti. So now, this shruti has a direct injunction of grihastha ashrama, therefore somebody says that there is only one ashrama. Because the authority is derived from Vedas, that there is a pratyaksha, a direct injunction only for grihastha ashrama. Therefore, other smrutis talking about four ashramas are all to be discarded. Then we have to establish that the smrutis talking about the four ashramas are also valid. A smruti can be valid provided there is a very clear statement in the shruti. So is there a clear statement of the four ashramas in the smruti? Yes, this is the one. So brahmacharyam samapya gruhi bhavet, gruhi bhutva vani bhavet, vani bhutva pravrajit. This very clearly talks about all the four ashramas. And therefore, the four chaturnam, what is it? Chaturnashramanam upeksha nasyat. So this pattern of the four ashramas derives its authority or validity from this direct statement of the Shruti. So brahmacharyam samapyedi pratyaksha shruti mulataha chaturnam ashramanam upeksha nasyat. Therefore, one cannot ignore the four ashramas because the idea of four ashrama also has authority from the statement of the Shruti. Anumanatah na upeksha. Anumana is smruti, by the way. So, very often smruti is referred to as anumana. Even in Purva Mimamsa. In the Purva Mimamsa also, the smruti is referred to as anumana. So, anumanatah, based on anumana smruti, you cannot do the upeksha of the four ashramas because the four ashramas derive their authority from the shruti. So, smruti cannot do the upeksha of the smruti. Smruti cannot do the upeksha of the shruti. That's the idea. Okay, we'll continue tomorrow. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah. Ishvaro Guru Ratmedi Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyomavat Vyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namah. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om.
Atma Yoyam Vijnanam Yah Praneshu Eshontarde Akashahe Tasmin Chede Sarvasya Vashi Sarvasya Shanahe Sarvasya Dipatihe तन साधुना कर्मणा भूयान्। नो एवा साधुना कनीयान्। एष सर्वेश्वरः। एष भूताधिपतिः। एष भूतपालः। एष सेतुर्विधरणः। एषां लोकानां संभेदाय तमेतं वेदानुवचनेन ब्राह्मणा विदिशन्ति। यज्ञेन दानेन तपसा नाशकेन एतमेव विदित्वा मुनिर्भवति। एतमेव प्रव्रायिनो लोकमिच्छन्तः प्रव्रजन्ति। एतद्भस्म वै तत्पूर्वे विद्वांसः प्रजान् कामयन्ते। किं प्रजया करिष्यामः। येषान्नोऽयमात्मा यल्लोक इति देहस्वपुत्रैषणायाश्च वित्तैषणायाश्च लोकैषणायाश्च व्युत्थाय अथ भिक्षाचर्यं चरन्ति। या ह्येव पुत्रैषणा सा वित्तैषणा। या वित्तैषणा सा लोकैषणा। उभे ह्येते एषण एव भवतः। स एषनेति नेत्यात्मा। अगृह्यो न हि गृह्यते। अशीर्यो न हि शीर्यते। असङ्गो न हि सज्जते। असितो न व्यसते। न इष्यते। एतमुहैवैतेन तरत इति। अतः पापमकरवमिति। अतः पुण्यम अतः कल्याणमकरवमिति। उभे उहै वैषेते तरते। नैनं कृताकृते तपतः। Page 1296, looking the Karoda Patra. Tasmad Atmanam Lokamichchantah Pravrajanti Pravrajayuhu iti esha vidhi arthavadena sangacchate. Tasmad Atmanam Lokamichchantah Pravrajanti eva. Therefore those desires of the world of the self, they definitely renounce, they should renounce. Establishing thereby the not only the necessity but also the fact that the renunciation of sannyasa is a valid state of life. Sannyasa is a valid state, is something enjoined by the scriptures. And that is what Vartikara comments upon here, wants to he explains. Nanuchatma prabodhena विधिगोचर लंघिनः कृतकृत्यस्य मुक्तस्य विधिरेष कथं भवेत्। दिस इज विधि फॉर हुम। तावत् अविदुषः विहितः सन्यासः न तावत् न तावत् विदुषः विहितः सन्यासः। सो यू आर सेइंग दैट दिस इज अ विधि फॉर सन्यास फॉर रेनन्सिएशन प्रव्रजेयुः इज फॉर हुम। न तावत् अविदुषः विहितः सन्यासः विद्वत् प्रकरण विरोधात्। दिस इज अ डिस्कशन ऑफ द वाइज पर्सन एंड देयरफॉर दिस विधि और एंजॉयमेंट ऑफ सन्यास कैन नॉट बी फॉर एन इग्नोरेंट पर्सन बिकॉज दिस इज अ डिस्कशन पर्टेनिंग टू द वाइज पर्सन। न विदुषः तस्य प्राप्त विद्याफलस्य विधि अयोगात्। And there cannot be vidhi or injunction for a person, for a wise person, tasya prapta vidya phalasya. Because he is the one who has achieved the vidya phalam, the result of the knowledge. The idea is that vidhi or injunction or any kind of a command will only be effective with reference to person who has a certain need. And this is prapta vidya phalasya, the person who has become free from the need. Well, he is not available for any command because he has nothing to gain and he has nothing to lose. Tasya karyam na vidyate, he has nothing now to do. There is nothing that he has to do. Karyam, kartavyam, that he has to do something, that he is free from this. And this is a freedom. So moksha, there are many ways of describing moksha. One of the ways with reference to the Vedic culture is that he is free from this kartavya, tasya karyam na vidyate. Therefore, nobody can oblige him to do something. See, whoever feels obliged to do something can be commanded. But he doesn't feel obliged to do anything because there is nothing to be gained by doing something, there is nothing to be lost by not doing something. Nanuch atma prabodhena vidhigocharalangina kritakrityasya muktasya. So, prapta vidya phalasya, krita krityasya, muktasya, one who is liberated, and then one has discovered the total fulfillment with one's own life. And therefore, vidhi gochara langinaha, one who has transcended this realm of vidhi and nisheda or injunctions. Vidhi eshaha katham bhavet, how can this pravrajayuhu be vidhi or command for a wise person? Vaidya sannyasa ayogadityartha. So, this is the Purvapaksha. Panchamoktam smaran pariyati. This has already been discussed earlier. Pariharosya chodyasya kahola brahmane khilah yato bhani maya purvam nehatah puna vachyade. Asya chodyasya akhilah pariharha kahola brahmane maya abhani. In kahola brahmana, this question has been already discussed in great detail, has been resolved, and therefore ataha iha punha na uchyate, and therefore here we do not see the need to discuss it again. So Tikagara said, sakshatkaravatova vaidasanyaso nirasyate apada jnanavatova. When you say that there cannot be sannyasa, are you saying that there is no sannyasa for the wise person, or for that is one with a paroksha jnanam, there is no sannyasa for that person, or there is no sannyasa for the person who is paroksha jnanam? Nadbhiha tasya vidya phalabhuta sannyasasya arthikatvena vaidatva anubhagavat. So, if you say that there is no vaidya sannyasa, so sannyasa taken by vidhi is not there for the wise person, we don't say it either because he is already a sannyasi. So by virtue of the knowledge, he is already a sannyasi, and therefore there is no need for him to take sannyasa by vidhi, you know. So he is already one, he is already something, you know. There is no need to formally do it because he already is. So vidhi means formal sannyasi. Nudvitiya. And you cannot, that means you cannot deny sannyasa for wise person. Then pravrajanti is arthika. So then they will necessarily renounce because they are already renunciates. And therefore you cannot deny sannyasa for the wise person, nor can you deny it for a seeker. Nadvitiya tasya sakshatkarodeshena sannyasasya anushtheyataya vidhi apekshatvat. Whereas for a mumukshu or jignasu, he requires sannyasa to lead a way of life which is compatible to or which is conducive to his pursuit of knowledge. Therefore, you cannot deny sannyasa for either of them, for an enlightened person or for a seeker.
Nanu vidushah avidushovana sannyasah aikashramyasrutehe गार्हस्ते अतिरेकेण आश्रमांतर अयोगाद अयिकाश्रम्यम तु आचार्यः प्रत्यक्ष विधानात् गार्हस्तस्येति Since the Vedas directly enjoin grihastashrama, and we do not seek an enjoinment of any other ashrama in the Vedas, therefore we say that there is only one ashrama, namely grihastashrama in life, and there is no scope for other ashramas, including sannyasa. Therefore we say that there is no sannyasa either for a vidwan or a vidwan. Satraha brahmacharyam samapyeti pratyaksha shruti mulataha chaturnam ashramanam syat nopeksha tonumanataha. So pratyaksha shruti mulataha, there is a pratyaksha shruti Javala Upanishad where he said all four ashramas are specifically mentioned. Brahmacharyam samapya gruhi bhavet, gruhi bhutva vani bhavet, vani bhutva pravrajet. That means all the four ashramas, the four stages of life, have a sanction in the Shruti where there is a direct statement. So, brahmacharyam samapyedi pratyaksha shruti mulataha chaturnam ashramanam upeksha nasyat anumanataha. So, anumanataha, anuman by Shruti.
Or, anumanataha, you can say that the Shruti, as it was discussed here, gains a validity only when it is sanctioned from the Shruti. However, suppose you don't find a Shruti statement to validate what the Shruti says, then you can infer that there must be a Shruti statement because the Shruti is there. So, Pratyaksha Shruti and Anumani Anumita Shruti. So, for Shruti statement, either Pratyaksha Shruti, that is direct statement of the Veda, is available, then there is no question, then we accept the Smriti also. But if direct statement is not available, then infer. We give the benefit of doubt to the Smritikara and infer that there must be a Smriti statement and accept the Smriti also as Pramanam. But where is the problem? Suppose what the Smritikara says contradicts what the Smriti says, then of course we have to discard the Smriti. This is the Vyavastha that has been determined in the Purva Mimamsa, that is what we talked about here. So, anumanata, by smriti, you cannot deny what the shruti says in so many words. So, next what Tikakara says. Shruti vashat, chaturashramya sambhavat, anumana shabdita, aikashram vishaya, smriti balat, na ashramantar upeksha ityatha. Shruti vashat, so, when anumitso anumanataha, when the word says, that word he explains, the shruti vashat, chaturashramya sambhavat, since there is a direct pratyaksha shruti statement, therefore all the four ashramas are possible, there is a sanction. Anumana shabdita aikashrama vishaya shruti balat. So anumana shabdita, what is meant by the word anumana in that verse? Aikashrama Shruti Balat. The Smriti, according to you, that is a Smriti statement which talks about only one ashrama. So on the strength of a statement like that, na ashramantar upeksha. You cannot overlook or you cannot deny the other ashramas on the strength of a Smriti. When we have a direct sanction from the Smriti, Shruti, with reference to all the four ashramas. Now continuing, the Tikagara says, we are on the page 1296, Tarhi Shrutehe Chaturashramyam Smrutehe Aikashramyam Cha Idi Samshasyat Dvayoho Api Pramanya Avisheshat. Then alright, Tarhi, if this is what you say, that we cannot discard the Shruti statement based on what the Smriti says, then the Purupakshi says, now we have two statements. We have the Shrutehe Chaturashramyam. So, from the Shruti statement that you just quoted, alright, the four ashramas should be there. Shrutehe Aikashramyam. Whereas from the Smriti statement that we just quoted, there is only one ashrama. Samshasyat. Then there will be doubt, what to do now? So when you want to
conduct yourself. And when there is a question, then you refer to the scriptures. So now you refer to Smriti, and this is what the Smriti says, only one ashrama. And the Shruti says, four ashrama, and therefore there is a doubt in your mind as to which instruction to follow. Samshaya, then this is Ubhaya Koti. When equally valid positions are there, then there is a doubt. Dvayoho api pramanya avisheshat. Then we say, oh, let us discard the Smriti. Says, no, dvayoho api pramanya avisheshat. Shruti also is pramana, Smriti also is pramana. Therefore, both of them are valid means of knowledge. Therefore, here we have two positions which are equally valid or which appear to be equally valid. Then the samshaya is there. Ataha, to this the Vartikara replies, Nachaiti. The next one. Nacha Vedaika Mulatva Virahat Syat Pramanata Acharasya Smrutirvapi Baudhadhyacharavat Dhruvam. He says, Nacha Vedaika Mulatva Virahat Pramanata Syat. So, if something does not have its mula, its source in the Veda, Veda eka mulatva viraha, Veda is the only pramana that is really accepted in the Indian culture, really, that's all. Veda is only pramana. Other things become pramana provided they have the sanction in the Vedas. So everything else derives its pramanam only from the Vedas. So, nacha Veda eka mulatva virahat. So the smriti that you are quoting does not seem to have the mula. So Veda eka mula, Veda should be the only source, and if that criterion is not satisfied, pramanata nasyat, then we cannot assign the validity, the authenticity to that. What? Acharasya. Any acharya, any code of conduct cannot have pramanata unless it is its source in the Vedas. Smriteirvapi. See, what happens is, Shishtachara is also looked upon as pramana, and Smriti also is looked upon as pramana. Athayade karma vichikitsava vritta vichikitsava syat ye tatra brahmana sammanashinah yukta ayuktaha aluksha dharma kama sihu yathade tatra varteran tatha tatra vartesaha. So whenever you doubt with reference to how to conduct yourself or what to do in a given ritual, then go to those people. Go to brahmanas and learned people who are sattvic, who are only wedded to dharma and who are honest and so forth. And so go to them. So this is Shishtachara. So Shruti, Smriti as well as Shishtachara. The achara, the conduct of the Shishta, of the people who are trustworthy and who are learned and who are good and pure. So their conduct also is looked upon as pramana. Acharasya Srutirvapi. But if that achara does not have its sanction in the Vedas, or the Smriti also is pramana, if that does not have sanction in the Vedas, then they do not have pramanata. Bauddhadi acharavat dhruvam. Like the achara, the Bauddha, so followers of Buddha, they also have all kinds of achara. They don't need pramanya at all. Siddha Thikagara, Tulya Nyayatvat Achara Grahanam. Same Nyaya. If something does not have its sanction of the Veda, then it doesn't gain Pramanya, whether it is Smriti or Achara. Therefore, Achara also is included as Shishtachara. Ayam Bhavaha, Thikagara says, Veda Moolaha Smritayaha Pramanam Tan Moolagamanam Manatvat. Veda Moolaha Smritayaha Pramanam. The smritis which have their moola, the source in Veda, they alone have the authenticity, the validity. Pramana means valid means of knowledge. Tan moola agamana manatvat. Because agamas are the Vedas, scriptures, which are the moola of the smriti, they are the pramana. Nacha aikatmash, nacha aikashramya smritehe moolam vedahasti. The smriti that you are quoting, which talks about only one ashrama, we do not find its moola in the Veda. We don't find such a statement in the Veda, which says only one stage of life, grihastha ashrama.
Then Tikakara says, Kutumbe, Shushaudeshe, Swadhyayam, Adhiyana, Ityadi tu, na ashramantaram apavadati. Kintu, Agnyasya, Avirektasya, Garhasyam, Anumodate. Kutumbe, Shushaudeshe, Kutumbe means in the family, Parivara. Shushaudeshe, is it? What is it? Shushaudeshe, in the place which is sanctified or clean, Swadhyayam Adhiyanah, so studying the Vedas, repeating the Vedas, all of these statement. So Kutumbe is there, no? That means this statement is applicable to everybody, he would say. This is a statement, I guess, coming from the Vedas, we will find the source of it. Ityaditu na ashramantaram apavadati. Just because this statement of the Veda talks about Kutumba does not mean that it discards or denies other stages of life, stages other than Grihastashrama are not denied. Then what does this statement do? Kintu Agnyasya Aviraktasya Garhastyam Anumodate. But for an ignorant person who doesn't have Vairagya, that means who has Asakti, that means who has a need, you know, to have things around himself, that's all. He needs an emotional support and all those things are required. That's fine, that also is valid. So, Garhastyam Anumodate. That statement in fact supports or concurs with the need of Grihastashrama for a person who doesn't have the Vairagya as yet. And so, Vedas will naturally, they are meant for everybody. And so, when a person has need of a company, need the emotional need is there, all these needs are there, he must necessarily be in an environment which is supportive of that need. So, a kutumba or a parivar provides a setup for a mutual support, you know. So, all similar people should be there. In that kutumba, one fellow is there who doesn't, you know, then that's the problem. All the people who are in a parivar must be similar. So, therefore, in that setup, each one supports the need of the other, and that's how a very beautiful parivara is there. And that is quite fine. So Garhastyam Anumodate, this is concurring or sanctioning the Garhastya of for the person who is in need. Nachastyam Smritau Ashramantra Asattvam Vivakshitam. Now, so maybe this is a Smriti statement, I don't know, this is coming from Grihastha, I mean Gautama, I guess. Kutumbe Shuchavadeshe Swadhyayam Adhiyanah. So the Gautama Smriti is in prose, you know, so perhaps this is a Smriti. Nachastyam Smritau Ashramantara Asattvam Vivakshitam. In that Smriti, Kutumbe Shuchavadeshe, so Ashramantara Asattvam Vivakshitam, there is no intention of saying that there is no ashrama other than Grihastha Ashrama.